Hi, I'm Ryan Kliethermes with KE2 Therm Solutions. In this video, I'm going to show you how to set a custom defrost schedule for the KE2 Temp plus Air Defrost controller. This is a feature of the defrost per day set point that allows you to determine the hour of each defrost cycle is performed, up to 12 per day. The first thing you need to do is enter the set points menu. To do this, press and hold the enter button. After 3 seconds, TS will appear on the screen. Use the up arrow to move to DPD. A short press on the enter button will display the current value. In order to go to the custom defrost schedule, though, we need to increase the value above 12 till CUS is displayed on the screen. Pressing holding the enter button will save our set point. Pressing the up arrow will display the time of day. A short press on the enter button will display the current time. The first thing that you'll notice is that the time format is the hour followed by the nearest 10 minutes. So to the left of the decimal is the hours in military time, and to the right of the arrow is the nearest minutes. You can use the up and down arrows to change the time to the current time. You can also use the enter button to go from minutes to hours. And then once you get the proper time set on the display, simply press and hold the enter button until TOD is displayed. So by default, each of the defrosts are disabled. So what we'll do is simply press the up arrow to go to the first defrost that we would like to enable. We'll have a short press on the enter button. You'll see by default, again, it's disabled. We'll simply use the down arrow. And again, you can see this uses military time, so this would be 11 p.m. So we use the up and down arrows to change that to exactly what time we would like that defrost to be performed. Once the proper time is on the display, simply press and hold the enter button until D1 is displayed. A short press on the enter button will validate that their set point change was made correctly. Then I simply press the back button to return to D1. Repeat the process that we use for D1 for each defrost cycle that you would like to be performed. A short press on the back button will return you to the default display of the controller. For more information, visit our website or contact our technical support line.